On the 25th of July, 2024, Google DeepMind announced that its AlphaProof and AlphaGeometry systems had together automatically solved 4 out of the 6 problems on the latest International Mathematical Olympiad. Here's the Lean 4 code that AlphaProof produced as a solution to problem number 2. I initially intended to make a video explaining this proof as is, but I quickly found the code to be difficult to make sense of, so instead I set out to clean it up. Without yet even fully understanding how the proof worked, I started chipping away at it, making small local changes that preserved proof validity. I consider this kind of incremental improvement to be significantly easier to do than finding a valid proof in the first place. AlphaProof did the hard work here. I'm just adding some polish. Eventually, I ended up with a proof that was much easier to follow, while still retaining the main ideas of the original output from AlphaProof. For the rest of the video, I will be explaining this proof step by step. Here's the initial goal. We want to prove equality of 2 sets. On the left, we have the set of pairs of positive integers AB, such that a certain sequence is eventually constant. On the right, we have the singleton set containing the pair 1, 1. Determining the exact form of that set on the right is actually an important part of the problem, and it's something that AlphaProof did automatically. But for this video, we are only going to focus on the proof, assuming that the explicit form has already been given. The nth element of the sequence in question is the greatest common divisor of a to the n plus b and b to the n plus a. Later, at the right moment, we will be choosing clever values of n which cause this expression to simplify favorably. But for now, the first step is to split the set equality into 2 cases, using the theorem set.eqsingleton if unique mem. The first case is the easy one. We need to prove that the pair 1, 1 satisfies the given constraint. Well, 1 is positive, and again, 1 is positive. We set g to be 2, and big N to be 1, and then after discharging a couple more trivial positivity constraints, and moving N into an hypothesis, we just need to show that the greatest common divisor of 1 to the N plus 1 and itself is 2. We rewrite 1 to the N as simply 1, and then the GCD self theorem closes out this goal. Now for the hard case. First, we use the rintro tactic to name all of our premises. This gives us positive integers a and b, such that the elements of the GCD sequence are eventually all equal to a natural number g. We need to prove that ab equals 1, 1. The key to the proof will be to consider the expression 1 plus a times b. One easy fact about this expression is that it is coprime with a. This follows from an application of the coprime add mul left right theorem, and then the coprime 1 right theorem. Similarly, 1 plus a times b is coprime with b, following entirely analogous reasoning. Next, we invoke the Pau-Totient theorem, yielding these 2 handy equivalences involving the expression phi of 1 plus a times b. This symbol phi represents Euler's totient function, which counts how many natural numbers are coprime with and less than its input. The 2 equivalences become even more handy if we cast them into equalities in the ring Z mod 1 plus A times B. This up arrow symbol means cast or coerce, and the destination type is implicit, so we're just going to have to remember that these equalities are all in the type Z mod 1 plus A times B. As a final preliminary fact, we note that phi of 1 plus a times b is positive. Now we claim that it suffices to show 1 plus a times b divides g. This gives us 2 new goals. 1, we need to prove that if 1 plus a times b divides g, then ab equals 1, 1. And 2, we need to prove that indeed 1 plus a times b does divide g. For the first goal, we start by specializing the GCD sequence at a very particular value, namely phi of 1 plus a times b times big N. Importantly, this value is greater than or equal to big N. Next, the nat.gcd-dvd theorem tells us that g divides both of the arguments of the GCD expression that it's defined by. Then, the transitivity of the divides relation tells us that 1 plus a times b also divides these 2 expressions. We now drop some no longer needed hypotheses, we cast into the type z mod 1 plus a times b, we push the cast operator inwards, and then we rewrite using the Euler-Totient equations we derived earlier. Now we rewrite 1 to the n as 1, we pull the cast operator back outwards, we convert back to the divides relation, we note that divides implies less than or equal to, and then we have something that can be finished by the n-linearith tactic. And now it's time to show that 1 plus a times b divides g. We claim that it suffices to show that there exists a natural number n greater than or equal to big N, such that 1 plus a times b divides both a times a to the n plus b and b times b to the n plus a. To prove that this does indeed suffice, we first unpack the existential. Then we use the DVD of DVD mole left theorem, together with our a coprime and b coprime hypotheses from earlier, to cancel the factors of a and b. Next, we use the DVD GCD theorem to deduce that 1 plus a times b divides the greatest common divisor of a to the n plus b and b to the n plus a. Finally, we note that because we've assumed n is large enough, this greatest common divisor is in fact exactly g itself, and so this subgoal is complete. Now we can drop a few hypotheses to tidy up a bit, and here we want to choose a value for n such that our Euler-Totient equalities can be used to maximal effect. We'll go with phi of 1 plus a times b times big N plus 1 minus 1. First, we need to show that this expression is larger than big N. Then we introduce a new variable w such that phi of 1 plus a times b equals w plus 1. As before, we cast into the type z mod 1 plus a times b. We push the cast operator inwards, we rewrite everything in terms of w, we split the conjunction, we distribute multiplication and move the leading a and b factors up into the exponents, we simplify the exponents, we rewrite with the Pau-Mull theorem, we rewrite with the Euler-Totient equalities, we simplify, we pull the cast operator back outwards, we convert back to divides relations, we normalize with the ring NF tactic, and then the DVD-Reffel theorem finishes the proof.